So in this example, we are going from picoseconds to kiloseconds. Now, if you look at this chart, you're going to see that there is no relationship between picoseconds and kiloseconds. So we have to actually go ahead and find a way to go to picoseconds from picoseconds to kiloseconds. So how can we do that? So go ahead and look at the ratios. What we can see is that from picoseconds, we can go to seconds, which is the base unit. And from kiloseconds also, we can go to seconds. So we are going to use that. Seconds is going to be something in common between both of those. So let's find the ratio of both of them to seconds. So as you know, over here, this is the base unit over here. So if you put the base unit after this, you will get the prefix over here. So what does that mean? If I were to put 10 raised to negative 12 seconds, that's going to equal 1 picosecond. In the same way, I can put on the other side for the kilo, 10 raised to 3 seconds is 1 kilosecond. So we go ahead and put the base unit seconds, or you can put meters, or you can put liters, any of those over there. And if you put it at the end over here, you can say, for example, 10 raised to 9 meters is equal to 1 gigameter. You can go ahead and do that. So once you've had that, let's think of the path we are going to take. We are actually going to go from picoseconds, sorry, this should be s, picoseconds to seconds, which is the base unit, and from there we are going to kiloseconds. Now, you can do this in two different parts. You can go do this in one part and then do this in the second part. But I'm going to recommend to do it together because in this class, as we keep going on, we're going to do multiple conversions and it's a good idea to keep it together. So let's start with what we are given. We are given 4.5 picoseconds and we have to multiply it with something so that we end up getting kiloseconds in the end. So we want the picoseconds to cancel out. So this is what we should do with our ratio. So this is what we're going to use as it is, 1 picosecond, and on the top, 10 raised to negative 12 seconds. Make a note at this point, check if the units cancel out. Yes, we are left with seconds. So then we can go ahead and do times. We want the seconds to cancel out and we want kiloseconds to remain. So this is the relationship between that. Can we write this exactly as it is over here? The answer is no, because if we do that, the units won't cancel out. So we have to reverse it. We put 1 kiloseconds on the top and 10 raised to 3 seconds on the bottom. So go ahead and solve this. So what I mean is everything on the top multiplied together. So multiply 4.5 with 10 raised to negative 2 times 1. And then divide all of it by 1 times 10 raised to negative, 10 raised to positive 3. So both of this should be on the bottom. And see if you're getting this as the answer for this question. You should get your answer as 4.5 times 10 raised to negative 5 kiloseconds. Please note over here you have 2 sig figs. So your final answer also should have 2 sig figs. And it's going to be in this format when written in scientific notation. So all of this is ratio or relationship. So we are not going to look at a sig figs from there. So this is how you do two conversions in one step. Let's look at another example, similar example. This time we're going from gallons to milliliters. So we see milliliters here. So here's milliliters, and we can see that 10 raised to negative 3 liters is 1 milliliter. So 10 raised to negative 3 liters is 1 milliliter. So we can go up and down here by using 10 raised to various exponents. But how do we go from gallons to milliliters? So if you look over here, you can see that 1 gallon is equal to 3.785 liters. So we can use that relationship. So we are going to say 3.785 liter is 1 gallon. So again, let's look at what we are going to plan. We have gallon, and from gallon we are going to liter, and from liter we are going to milliliter. So we will start with 3.2 gallons. All the rest are going to be ratios, so our final answer should have 2 sig figs. So we want gallons on the bottom and liter on the top. So we have 1 gallon and 3.785 liters. So we will see that the gallon and gallon cancels out. We are just left with liter. Now we want to get rid of the liter and end up with just milliliter. So if you go ahead and put 10 raised to negative 3 liter is 1 milliliter. So we are using this relationship now. And solve this out and see what you're getting as your answer. So you will get something like this: 38.7584 times 10 raised to positive 3 milliliter. Now remember, write this in scientific notation, and we need 2 sig figs. So when you write it in scientific notation, it should end up being 3.9 times 10 raised to positive 14 milliliters. We do look at this number, and because of that, we are going to round this and make it a 9.